Good day, guys. Welcome to my hurricane forecast. In this forecast, I'm going to be talking about if Tropical Disturbance 1 will develop. So, Tropical Disturbance 1 currently has a 10% chance of formation within the next 5 days and also a 10% chance of formation within the next 40 hours. The reason why this system has such a low chance of formation is because upper level winds are not forecast to be favorable for development, and this system is going to get ripped apart by wind shear. So guys, the wind shear is going to inhibit the development of this system, and if this system does attempt to develop, it will move out to sea, and that would be far out into the future. But as of now, we're not anticipating development of the system, and if the system does attempt to develop, as I said, it's going to be out to sea and not in that environment, because in that environment the conditions seem not favorable for development. But if this system heads into a more favorable environment, it will attempt to develop, as some of the models show. But right now that seems uncertain. So guys, this system currently has a 10% chance of formation within the next 5 days and also a 10% chance of formation within the next 48 hours. So we're not expecting development within the next 5 days nor within the next 48 hours. The both chances are low for us to see a tropical depression or a tropical storm form within the next 5 days or so from this system. So regardless of what, we're going to continue to monitor this system, and this system is going to continue to produce heavy rainfalls upon the Bahamas, but still the system is going to be moving away from that area. So this system, you would see likely less impacts from this system. So guys, if you live in the Bahamas, you're going to see a decrease in the amount of moisture that you're currently seeing in your area. And the only reason why you saw an increase in moisture was because of this tropical disturbance that passed right along your area. So guys, I'm going to keep you guys posted on this system. Now I'm going to move her towards forecast models on this system. So this is currently the European model, and this is the model that we're going to be running, this model and also the GFS model on this system. So guys, let's start to run the model. So as we start to run the model, we see that this system gets fairly more somewhat, the vorticity seems to get more tight, but it's not showing a very certified low pressure center, which means that I'm not expecting this to be a tropical storm nor a tropical depression at this point, just because of the amount of wind shear that's in the area. So as I said, there's very little wind shear. There's not lots of wind shear that's going to be in the area that this system might head in the long term. So maybe it will have a chance of development, but as I said, as of now, we're not anticipating development of this system. And if it does, it would be in the sometime in the near future from now. But as I said, I'm not expecting development of this system. But there is a decrease in the wind shear that this system might be headed in. So if it does try to get organized, it might get organized little and a little bit. But we're not expecting rapid development of this system. We're not expecting the system to quickly organize. But as I said, there is an area that there's little wind shear in, and I'm going to show you guys that on the GFS model. So guys, this is the wind shear. So you can see that we see this system is currently in this general area. So this is our system. Our system is getting battered by wind shear at this time. So that's why it seems very disorganized. So we're going to start to run the model on this to see if it rides out all of that wind shear. So we see this system head into an area where you can see there's a break in the wind shear in this general area. So that tells me is that if this system does attempt to move in that area, as I said, there might be some development of this system, but we're not expecting rapid development of this system, and it will be very slow to occur. So we're not expecting development of this system, but you could still actually see that this system is still in an area that has lots of wind shear. But if this system moves more to the south, it's going to head into a more favorable wind shear environment. So Maybe the system will develop if it does attempt to ride out that wind shear, but as I just showed you, there is a break in the wind shear, so if this system does move into that area, maybe it would try to intensify slightly, but not a tropical depression, not a tropical storm. None of those we're not expecting at this time. So guys, we're going to now end this forecast because this system is not a major concern as of now, but we're still going to keep an eye on this system. So thank you guys for watching this video.